Hi, welcome to part 14 of making a guitar in your garage. My name's Andy Evans. Okay, so on this podcast we're going to make a fingerboard. I'm actually going to use some teak because I have some teak lying around that I've cut down. So teak is quite very stable. They use it on boats, on the decks of boats. It's very stable, it doesn't move. It's nearly as hard as maple. It looks quite attractive when you lacquer it, which is what I'll have to do, because it changes. If you don't lacquer it, it goes grey, and the grain opens up and it looks pretty horrible. But you can lacquer it, you can stain it. A clear lacquer, it will look like a golden colour. It's a bit nicer looking than maple. So I've got a piece of 8mm teak here. It's a little bit on the thin side, I should have made it a bit thicker, but I did it on my table saw, so I'm hoping this is going to be okay. So there's a couple of ways of marking your frets and cutting them. One is by hand, with a straight edge down the middle and a protractor. A protractor is a semicircle with a centre line down the middle and a 90 degree angle here. I'm sure you know what a protractor is. Okay, so what you do, you draw a centre line, and then with your protractor you'd mark out the frets. Obviously, before you do that you need some guide. In the olden days, 30 years ago, I've actually defretted a guitar, marked through with a small blade, and made a template for where the frets go. Nowadays you can buy templates off the internet, and it's probably the easiest way to do it, actually, is just buy one. If you don't want to do that, you can copy, get a friend's guitar, Strat, something like that, or a Gibson, just copy where the frets are, just mark them out onto a piece of wood using a knife, and then put that on your guitar neck, and using a straight edge and a protractor, you mark each fret. I'm not going to do it that way. I've actually got a template. This is a Stuart McDonald template. And you use it with a jig like this. I'll come closer to the camera so you can see. This has got a Gibson long scale and it's got a Gibson short scale on it. And if you look closely, it has little pips here, locating pips where the frets are going to go. You can mark these by hand with a pencil, or you can use this with a jig like this, which I've made. This is basically, these are 90 degree angles. It's just a piece of wood like this, with a 90 degree cut across here, which I've done by hand with a very thin fret saw. And then all you need at the bottom of this jig template is a locating pip. I'll bring it really close to the camera so you can see. There's a drill bit here that I drilled through, and then I just snap the drill bit off. It's like a 2mm drill bit. Now that little drill piece there will locate with the locating holes of this. So if I put this inside, it catches like this, and then you put your fingerboard inside here. You fasten it to this piece of plastic, either screw it or double-sided tape. I prefer screws. And then you move, cut another slot, move a bit more, cut another slot, move a bit more, cut a slot. I don't know if you can see this. Move the template like this, cut a slot. And that's how you make your template. This piece of wood fastens onto here. You put that right to the edge like this, like that. You screw it, drill a pilot hole first because you don't want to crack the wood. Screw it here. I'm going to do that right now. Bang, screw in. So that's the rough sawn edge here, that's the planed edge. I'm going to put the planed edge down like that. Turn it over. Turn the edge to that. I'm going to drill some pilot holes. I don't know if you can see this. again. So just some pilot holes. Like that. And then I'll put a couple of little screws in, just to stop it from moving. One screw. If you don't want to make a fingerboard, you can buy them on the internet. 20 or 30 euro, you get a fingerboard, you know, in ebony or rosewood. That's the easiest way to do it, really. If you want to make one, you can either mark them by hand, as I said earlier, you know, copy a Fender or a Gibson, make a little template, and then mark them, then score them with a blade, cut them all out by hand. If you cannot get a fret saw, you can get you can use a blunt metal hacksaw. You can use a blunt metal hacksaw, and that'll just about do the fret slots the right width. But obviously, practice on a piece of scrap wood first. Make sure the frets are the correct size. So that's screwed to the template. I bang that in there like this. Make sure I'm doing the right side, Gibson long, yep. And basically, you put that in, it locates with the pip, like that. Use your fret saw, this is a fret saw. Put that in there, put this in here, like that. That's a nice saw, very, very simple. Obviously you don't want to go too deep, so I'd put some type of marker on here, you know, a bit of tape or something, so you can see what you're doing. So there's one fret slot. Then you lift it, you move it to the next locating pip, and you do another one. And so on and so forth. So you carry on doing that, and eventually you end up with a fretted fingerboard. This is one I did earlier. It's got 24 frets in it, Gibson modern scale. The next stage would be to do a centre line on this, draw a centre line. Draw a centre line right down the middle, exactly down the middle of here. Measure, this is the nut end here, I'll cut that piece off. My next is going to be 43, so I need to measure 21 and a half from the centre line. 21 and a half here, and then measure. So basically, I'm measuring 43 here, 21 and a half either side of the centre line. Do the same thing at this end, 58, half of 58. Do a centre line, and then half of 58 is 29. So you do 29 mil there, and 58 here. And then you cut that out. To make sure I put my neck on it first, like this, right on the end where it's going, draw it, and then you cut this out here, and that gives you the dimensions, and then you're going to glue this onto your neck. Okay, so that's what I'm going to do next. I'm going to mark all this out, cut it to the right measurement so it fits onto here. Then I'm going to do the I'm going to scoop it out a little bit like a U, you know, a U shape, like I mentioned before, so you get that nice join U shape here, just with a cabinet scraper, and then glue it, just clamp it, wood glue, clamp it, glue it. You don't want to glue it onto the table like this, you know, because you want it glued onto whatever, to this, onto the neck, you know. As I was saying earlier, you want this slightly bent forward with nothing on the truss rod. So that's the next thing we want to do, glue it. Once you're happy with, once you've cut it out and you're ready to glue it on, one thing you can do, you can use a very, very small drill, in the drill bit. You can drill through either where a dot is going to go, an inlay is going to go, or you can drill through a fret slot. Drill through a fret slot here, 2mm drill, really small. And you can use a couple of cocktail sticks, put those through, and you can use those as locating holes to make, you know, get your fingerboard lined up. Use those, because sometimes when you glue it, it wants to move around, you know, and you don't want that happening. You want this exactly, the frets exactly square to the neck. So that's what I'd do. I'd drill through, use a couple of cocktail sticks, put them through the frets or where your dots are going to go. I'm not going to put dots on this. I personally don't like dots. I'm going to put a marker at the 12th fret, but maybe a marker at the 24th fret. And obviously I'm going to put some side dots here, so it's not too difficult, but I have quite like a clean fingerboard, clean look to it. Okay, so that's the next step on the next podcast. Okay, I'm going to do that today. I'm going to stay busy cutting that out, sticking it on. So the next podcast, you'll see this cut out, glued on to the fingerboard. And then it's basically ready to be glued onto the... I'll have to radius the fingerboard, yes. So that's the next thing. Once it's all glued together, I'll radius the fingerboard. I'm going to do a part of a 12-inch radius here. I don't know what that is in millimetres. And part of a 10-inch radius here. I'll have to figure out what that is in millimetres. A long time ago when I started guitar making, 30 years ago, I did everything in inches, but I've actually forgot, because in the 80s, I think it was, the mid-80s, we went over to metric. So I started off in inches and eventually changed to metric, and now I forgot how to use inches. But that's the end of the podcast. I'll see you next time. Happy guitar making. Any comments, please leave me a comment or press the subscribe button. Leave me a comment, and I'll see you next time.